train of empties approaching the signals controlling the line into Black Thunder. Another train has just gone into the Black Thunder mine, so this one may have to wait a while here. And it has come to a stop.
They cost anywhere from $11,000 to $18,000. They're 12 feet in diameter and 9 feet wide. As you see, these trucks are setting on what is called a ready line. A ready line is a mini loop station. The slump has fallen off of it. You can see it's very steep from the dirt itself.
70-foot seam of coal.
It's pretty much soft, it's not a hard coal. I'll tell you about our mining procedure, but you'll understand it more once we get to another area. What we do is we take the topsoil off the top, the seda made in Wisconsin. It cost $1.5 million a piece. As I mentioned, they have the diesel engine that generates power to run the electric wheel motors. Their boxes hold 320 cubic yards, which is equivalent to 2.4 train car loads. Everyone out here is cross-trained. That's how their pay is based. Those who drive the trucks can also run the graders and the scrapers, such as these over here. This up here is our near pit crush to the little conveyor belt, hits the overland conveyor belt, and leads directly to the plant area. On our left is our scoreboard. Our scoreboard ends have been crushed per shift. Flashing lights indicate which hopper they can dump into. It guides the truck drivers into which hopper they can dump and when. If the green lights flash, it actually bakes it. And this is what this mixture is. It's what we call scoria. We use it for traction. Yeah, this is the Thor drive. We have names for each of these. Its boom is 315 feet. Its bucket is 90 cubic yards. And it weighs 7.6 million pounds. Feel this coal seam. And as you can see, it just scoops up the dirt in front of it and puts it into these spoil piles here and works back. Excuse me. What we're doing down there is we're taking off the top layer of coal. The reason is because this is where the dirt ended and the coal began. And since it's mixed with the dirt and dirt doesn't burn, we don't bother mining it, so we just take it off. We do, however, mine 98% of the coal seam.
Is that coal useful for anything?
No. As you can see, you saw those that smaller truck. Well, what we do is we just put it into another kind of like a dump area in the spoil piles, and then that'll just go back down into the ground.
I wondered if it would even work for paving, gravel roads or anything.
Yeah, as far as I know, we don't do anything else but just dump it back in.
Is there a lot of dust with the main seam of coal?
Not too bad, because we do, like I said, we do keep the roadways down. The coal itself does give off some dust, but not too bad. As you can see, what'll happen is there's a road that comes down here. What we'll do is bring a shovel. It'll shovel the coal out and head behind the drag line. There'll be an empty hole there. Then what we'll do is we'll cast blast that material, that high wall, into this hole. Then what'll happen is this will be covered. That coal seam will be revealed, and the drag line will work back this way. And then the next coal seam will go back that way, and back this way, and so forth. It just works in a zigzag pattern. The drag lines are too heavy to be put onto tracks or onto tires, so they walk. They have pads on either side of them. Sits the pads down, picks up the equipment, scoots it back, sits down, then picks up the pads again. And that's what he might be doing right now. He might walk, I'm not too sure. It walks backwards.
How long does it take to walk it, you think?
It goes 7 foot per step, and it just depends. So
it's not tracked at all. It's
right.
Only on the feet.
Do you know what the big bird is?
That's probably a hawk.
Looks very big.
It's either a hawk or an eagle, but I think it's a hawk.
distance, a UP train stands in Bill Yards, waiting to head north. At this point, it appears grading is in hand to install a second track. Still not come into view over the hill. WUP train waiting to take its empties north to the mines. It has a leased X Santa Fe C30-7 as the second unit. This is the second of these we've seen in the last few days. Interesting how quiet the coal cars are on this ribbon rail. just north of Ville. We've had about an hour and a half's wait. 9 trains of empties are standing down there, and this is the first of them getting underway. At 3:54, we're hoping that the log jam of trains is cleared. Thank you. ago, the air was still. Now it's a raging breeze. The Burlington train was the first to pull up to the signals. The first train away northwards is a Chicago and Northwestern. And this is the 8th train in the sequence. 524. Traffic jam of coal trains down the Orin line south to Douglas. This one has exotic motive power. A merger painted C30-7, leased from GE, having been traded in by Santa Fe. Location is Lightning Creek. 21. We've caught up with our old friends again. The train now doesn't have a crew. It's waiting to be passed by another southbound. Common to see Kansas City Southern units on trains exiting via the north, but not common to see them on this particular part of the coal line. This train is taking the new line, which connects the old Chicago and Northwestern tracks with the Union Pacific. Trains are in the passing siding together. The front one appears to have stopped. So they may well be preparing a double meet. Thank you. end of the previous train can just be seen on the horizon. helper set runs back to push a train, and the merchandise train has a helper set on the point, heading for Alliance. The old route diverges to the right and went through a tunnel. The route to the left that this train is on is the new 1970s route.